Hello, what's up you guys and welcome. My name is Michael Novak and a little over a year ago I graduated high school, and in that time that I was in high school I learned quite a few things about myself and about the way that high school works in terms of social cliques. So I thought I'd just share a few tips with you because I know a lot of you guys from the US are starting high school right about now, and in a lot of European countries you've started about a month ago. Now these tips are gonna be about how to socialize and how to become a better version of yourself and how to develop throughout high school on a personal level, and not about how to get through the subjects and how to cheat or like life hacks or whatever. So I just wanted to share 10 tips with you on how to survive high school. I hope you'll be able to use it, and let's get going. Number one, be social with people from day one. You have to interact with your classmates and the people around you from day one. When you're starting in a new class with new people, the first week is the most important, and you don't want to fuck it up. It's kind of like in a race, right? Like a speed race. The person who gets the best start often wins. It's the same with high school. You want to be part of the social life in your class, you have to start talking with people and being social from day one. It is so important. I learned it the hard way. So just, I know it's hard, I know it's really hard, but after the first week or two, you know, it'll all be over. You'll have created social groups with people in your class and whatnot, and those will be consistent throughout the time that you're in high school, throughout the year at least. So it's really beneficial. Number two, try to make friends. This is kind of the same as the first one, but with this, I mean, for your personal sake. When I started high school in the first couple of months, I just sat on my laptop, like throughout the day. I didn't really talk to that many people in my class. I just kept to myself, thought to myself, you know, I'm not here to make friends. I'm here to get an education. I'm just gonna mind my own business, do my own thing. But that sucks. Like, that will make the days go by so slowly. It's just way more fun to be anywhere if you're part of the social group, you know, and if you have people to talk to. Number three, also, everyone is as nervous as you in the first couple of days, in the first week, in the first time that you start out. In the event that nobody knows each other from previously, you know, people will be nervous. And therefore, you just have to be open. You have the upper hand here. Nobody knows who you are. You can form an entirely new identity. You can choose how you want to communicate with people, how you want to socialize. You just got to choose a version of yourself to become. And just be open. Everyone is nervous, so they're not going to be mean to you in the first few days. They're not. So you have to, you know, make that good start. Number four, if there are any extracurricular courses, take them. Seriously. It's a great way to form those friendships that'll last even longer than high school. Number five, make an effort. I know this sounds really boring and really simple, and it should go without saying, but I feel like it's really important to mention that if you study, if you take notes, if you try to sort of focus on class, not only will you become better at the subjects, but you'll realize that time flies by so much faster if you just sort of interact and take it seriously, instead of being like, oh, not again, not math again, or whatever, because again, that'll make the time go by so slow. Number six, exams are extremely hard, but it's one of those things that you just have to get through. I know it sucks, but you have to do it, you know? A good tip here is if your high school offers any exam stress relief courses after class, join them. I did, and it really helped me a lot, because I was really nervous. But it made me really calm down. We sat in a group and we talked about not so much physically what to do to get by an exam, but how it affects us with all the stress and all of these things. And we sat there and we talked as human beings. And it all was brought down to a lower level, a more sort of human level, instead of just, here you have a piece of paper or whatever and you have to just nail it, you know? That can be, I mean, it worked for me, so you might want to try it out. Number seven. Remember to stay calm. Now, I'm bringing this tip in, especially because of this video that you can watch in the note cards. It's a poem by Jane Coizan. It's called Instructions for a Bad Day. It's just important to remember that everyone can have a bad day, and that's okay, seriously. If you have a shitty day, that's okay. Like I said, the most important thing is just in the first week or two, just to be, you know, on, just to be fucking, you know, doing it, you know, be social and just interact. But after that, I mean, it's okay to have a shitty day and you know, look around at other people, because I'm sure a lot of other people might be having shitty days as well. And just, I don't know, walk up to them, try to talk to them, try to make them feel better about it, because, you know, make them realize that it's okay. I mean, the most important thing, if you're not enjoying high school, is to focus on everything else in your life and just try to keep focus on that and just view high school as something you just have to get through. But focus on when the hour hits and you're off for the day, or when it's the weekend or the vacation or whatever, focus on everything else in your life. You know, that'll make you go get by without going insane. Number 8, remember, don't take it too seriously. It's just 4 years, depending on where you are, it could be more or less. And then it's over, and you're on to something new. And the people that you don't like, you never have to interact with them again. You never have to socialize with them again. It's all temporary. So just keep that in mind and hang in there, you know? Number 9, remember, you are not obligated to do anything. It's your life and it's your choices. If you truly aren't enjoying being in high school and it's not for you, then drop out. Alternatively, you can change high school if the problem is that you're getting bullied or whatever. But if it's not for you, then it's not for you. Drop out and do something completely different. It's not the end of the world, seriously. You can do something else. You will get by, you will survive, and you will be happy, even if you don't take high school or college or whatever. Just remember, you're not obligated to do anything. You know what I mean? It's you make your own choices and you form your own life. You take choices and then you deal with the consequences of those. I just don't believe that you should ever wake up in the morning wishing that you were dead. You know? If you truly aren't comfortable, then just drop out. I mean, throughout most of high school, I felt that way when I woke up in the morning. I wanted to die, you know what I mean? I didn't want to be there. Like, it wasn't so much because of the people, but just simply because of the courses. Like, it just was so uninteresting for me, the majority of the classes. I got through it though in the end, because I'm a competitive person, and if I start something, I finish it. But, you know, I hated it for the majority of the time. I just want to be honest about that. You know, it was boring as fuck. What can I say? Number 10, use your time affectionately. High school is not so much about the courses and whatnot. It's more about the personal sort of change in you. It's more about how you develop as a person. You know, use it to figure out what you want to do with the rest of your life, or at least get an idea of where you're heading. You know, it's a great sort of way to breathe after middle school or whatever came before you. It's a great way to sort of just sit down and think, what am I interested in? What do I want to do? Is college something that's going to be for me, or do I want to do something completely different afterwards? But most importantly, it's just about having fun, and it's just about learning new things about yourself and trying new things out. So just, you know, be open and hang in there. All right, that was my 10 tips on how to survive high school. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you'll be able to use it for something. I'm gonna get going. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't. Check out my last 10 tips video that I did. I'm becoming like Matthew Santoro, I realize that. But you can check that out in the note cards as well. And I just want to say thank you so much for watching, and thank you to Arcane Media Group for helping me out with the intro. There's a link to their Facebook page in the description. Be sure to go check it out. All right, I'll see you guys next week. Bye.
Thank you for watching. If you'd like to see more videos like this, then please click here. If you'd like to see a random video from my channel, then click here. Also, be sure to subscribe. And I'll see you next time. Goodbye.